Hello and welcome to yet another episode of Cooking with T-Zack. Cooking with T-Zack. Should we come up with a theme song? Okay. Today's recipe is extra special because it's probably the simplest, easiest recipe I've ever posted, shown, demonstrated on Cooking with T-Zack in the last 14 months or so of showing you all these recipes. Okay, and I'm not kidding. I've shown you a fair number of really easy recipes, and this one's really, really easy. But it's also one of the most delicious, and you'll see why. Only when you cook it for yourself. But today's recipe is the Goalondo steamer chicken curry. And the Goalondo steamer chicken curry story is really peculiar and interesting. It actually goes back about 150 years. So this is like British times, colonial times. And Goalondo is a small town in East Bengal, now Bangladesh. But back in the times of undivided India, it was East Bengal. It used to be a port, a very major port for travelers stopping by between Kolkata and Dhaka, or Calcutta and Dhaka. And that's where they would stop, where the railways would stop, and they would have to transfer onto a steamer boat. And this curry, this chicken curry, is something that the boatmen on these steamers would cook, initially for themselves, but then eventually for the travelers, with very basic ingredients and little to no effort. And eventually it became, I mean, because it's delicious by nature, it's almost like magical how amazing this curry is. It became really popular. It's become a very significant part of Bengali cuisine folklore. And today I'm going to share it with you. This is a recipe I learned from Iti Mishra. Shout out to Iti Mishra. And the reason why I have this very interesting oil here, which I came across recently, is because this recipe uses a significant amount of oil. So you want to make sure you use really good oil. This is a company called Azafran, which manufactures organic cold press oils. They have an entire range of organic cold press oils. And for those of you who are not familiar with cold pressing, typically mass manufactured oils use heat to manufacture the oils, to produce the oils. And that heat applied to oils would kind of deteriorate the natural nutrients present in those oils. And each of these oils have different properties which are great for your health. And also, heat also deteriorates flavor. So for example, this organic mustard oil, for example, also known as kachi gani, traditionally, has a wonderful aroma of mustard. It's made from mustard seed sourced from Rajasthan. It's delicious, also great for you and great for the environment because it's organic, which means no chemicals, fertilizers used in the production of the mustard seeds themselves. Okay, so should we get into the ingredients of this super simple chicken curry, which I'm sure you're gonna love. Okay, here we go. So we have chicken leg and thigh on the bone. We have finely chopped garlic, chopped green chilies, chopped ginger, sliced onions, turmeric powder, red chili powder, non-spicy Kashmiri red chili powder, and Azafran's organic mustard oil. All right, so let's get cooking, shall we? Now that we have all our ingredients ready, very few ingredients, if you ask me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 ingredients, including salt, and usually I don't count salt as one of the ingredients. Just 2 steps to this ingredient, to this recipe. You mix all the ingredients together and then you cook it. Simple. So we're gonna start. Okay. We're gonna start with marinating the chicken. And this is really, really simple. You have all your aromatics. So finely chopped ginger is gonna go in. You're gonna have your finely chopped green chili, which is gonna go in. the chopped garlic, finely chopped. That's going to go in as well. Generous with these. Then you have your sliced onions. Now, I like onions, so I'm going to put a lot of them. There's about maybe 2 cups of it for 1 kilo of chicken. There's going to be about 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder. About 3 teaspoons of red chili powder. Generous amount of salt. And our mustard oil. It's very important that you use mustard in the recipe, that makes or breaks this dish. And in this case, I'm using the organic cold pressed mustard oil from Azafran. And this dish actually needs a lot of oil. So I would say about 1/2 to 3/4 cup. And don't be ashamed or don't be scared of too much oil like this. It's not bad for you. It's actually good. It's zero cholesterol, rich in omega acids, rich in kind of antioxidants. And then you mix all of these together. Okay. This part is fun as well. So just go crazy. Get your hands dirty. If you have kids at home, you know, get them involved. Start them young, you know what I mean? And yeah, you have this mixture, which is now your chicken marinade. And what it tastes is. Seasoning is on point. And let this marinate for about an hour at least. You can marinate overnight, but at least an hour or a couple of hours. And then we'll get to the cooking stage. Okay, so I'm going to be back in an hour. Alright, chicken's been marinating for an hour. I would have liked to keep it longer, but I don't have that kind of time anymore. I'm really busy with nothing. We're gonna start cooking. Now, literally, like I said, like this recipe is 2 steps. Marinate the chicken, cook the chicken. We got this pan here, and you want a pan which you have a lid for. And as soon as the pan heats up a little bit, add your chicken with everything else, the marinated chicken with all the other ingredients in there, including the onions, spices, the oil, the Azafran's cold pressed organic oil, and then cover and cook on a low flame until the chicken's cooked through. All right, it should take about 20 minutes, but come and check on it every now and then. All right. Okay, about 7 minutes are up. At this stage, I'm gonna just check on this curry. Maybe stir it a little bit. Make sure that it gets all nicely mixed up. Delicious. And cover and continue to cook. You really don't need to keep mixing it around. That's enough. All right. I think about 25 to 30 minutes is up. So a little longer than 20 minutes, I promised you. But chicken curry is finally ready and we can turn it off. And a good way to check whether it's actually ready is to get a sharp paring knife and insert it into the chicken pieces. And typically, if it goes through and comes out without actually pulling back the chicken back up, it's typically cooked. But you could also kind of maybe taste some of the pieces or kind of press it down like that. But this chicken is done, and that's it. Your Goalondo Seema chicken curry is ready. Imagine zero water. We actually cooked this without any water. I mean, have you come across a chicken curry which has no water in it? I haven't, and this is one. Let's taste. There's a lot of oil floating on top, and that's kind of customary for this particular chicken curry. And that's why it's important to have really good quality cold pressed mustard oil. This one's from Azafran. Oh man. Okay, there's a little bit of that kick from the chilies. But this is a very, very special chicken curry. Not just because it's really simple, but it's I can't place it. I don't know why it's so special, but it's magical. And I implore all of you to actually try it at home. Let it cool down. Because as it cools down, all these flavors are gonna come together. And maybe even wait the next day. But this is gonna be perfect on top of some rice, and that's all you need. Oh my god, okay. I'm getting excited just thinking about it. But enjoy cooking a teesak, and can't wait to see the results. Alright? Peace!